More than 70 United Nations aid workers have been killed in Gaza since October 7th, when the current hostilities began. On Friday, here at the UN, Martin Griffiths, the top UN humanitarian official, became emotional when he began speaking about those losses.
One of the terrible things about that, those killings, are that most of them have happened in the homes of those people, and they have been killed with their families. I think it's the highest number of UN staff lost in a conflict.
The United Nations is providing shelter for more than 650,000 displaced people in Gaza. But an official said that the bombardment by Israel has become so intense, even the United Nations cannot guarantee the safety of the people that need it the most.
We've had over 50 of our facilities that have been impacted by the conflict, including 5 direct hits. I think at last count, 38 people have died in our shelters. I fear that with the fighting going on in the north right now, that number is going to grow significantly. These are people seeking shelter under a UN flag, seeking protection under international humanitarian law.
The UN reports in the last 10 days, a total of 329 aid trucks have reached Gaza through the Rafah crossing. But officials say that's not nearly enough. Before October 7th, about 500 aid trucks got to Gaza every single day.
Make sure to subscribe to a channel to the latest news from RDZ World News.